Hello students, good morning. See, in a previous video we have seen the equation of Newton's first equation using graphical method. We are learning the equation of motion using graphical method. See, in that first equation we have already seen there are totally three equations which are discovered by scientist Newton. That is nothing but the first one is the V is equal to U plus AT, I think. Second one is the S is equal to UT plus 1/2 AT square. And third one is the V square is equal to U square plus 2AS. See, these three equations are discovered by scientist Newton using graphical method. These equations are known as equations of motion which are discovered by scientist Newton. See, don't change the sequence of these equation. First remains as a first, second is always second, and third is always second. Don't change the sequence of these equations, because the equation third depend on equation second and equation second depend on equation first. That's why I told here that don't change the sequence of these equations. Equation number first we have already seen the equation describing about the speed and time. This equation in today's lecture or today's video we are going to learn equation number 2 which are discovered by scientist Newton, and that is nothing but the equation of motion 2. What is the equation? Equation is UT plus 1/2 AT square. See, here is the diagram which we have already seen in a equation first. See, I wanna again tell you. See, here is the graphical, by using graphical method. Therefore, here is the graph, here is the x-axis, here is the y-axis. On x-axis, the velocity, on x-axis, time is note down here. On y-axis, the velocity note down here. See, the object start to moving from point A to point B. At the point A, the initial velocity of object is u. At the point B, the initial velocity of object to cover the point C is the final velocity, that is nothing but the v. And for our consideration, for our satisfaction, we draw here new line from B to D on a x-axis, and the distance covered by is the BD. Okay, like this. This is a graphical representation of this equation. See, what is equation says here? Said here, S is equal to UT plus 1/2 AT square. See, here is the S is nothing but the distance. When we want to calculate distance of any object, we must take there the area of any rectangle. Okay. See, the object is moving in a uniform motion. Here is the object is moving in uniform motion. All of you know that what is mean by uniform motion. Sorry, uniform motion, or here I want to write uniform acceleration. Actually, see, object is a moving in uniform acceleration in a distance s. In distance s, or the distance covered by, when object is moving in uniform motion, the distance covered by object is s. Okay, isn't it? In time t. Okay, so how the acceleration is calculated? The acceleration is calculated using formula. All of you know that A is equal to V minus U divided by T is known as acceleration. Formula for acceleration. See, here U is also here. Here is also U. Here is the T. Here is also A. Okay? Means this equation is related with this equation? Yes. this equation is related with this equation. Therefore, I say here the object is moving in uniform motion. At that time, the distance covered by object is s. And what time required for that object to cover that distance s is the t. See, here we want to calculate s. S is nothing but the distance. And when we are going to calculate distance, always there is a take s symbol for a distance. How to calculate the distance covered by object by using this graphical method? See, by using these two factor. Which two factor? See, here are the movement of object is shown in a this graph. See, here is the two factor. Which two factor? Here is the triangle ABE and here is the rectangle AEDO. Okay, and these two factors describing the distance covered by an object. Therefore, if I want to calculate distance, I must take here the area of rectangle. Big rectangle. See, the rectangle ABDO is made up from these two factors. See, area of ABDO is made up from two factors. Which two factors? The area of rectangle AEDO and the area of triangle, right angle triangle ABE. Therefore, I write here the area of rectangle ABDO is equal to area of rectangle AEDO plus area of is equal to nothing but area of rectangle triangle, sorry, right angle triangle ABE. Okay, now we calculate here the areas of these two. See, area of AEDO means what? The area of AEDO means it is nothing but the, how to calculate the area of any rectangle? It's a length into breadth. Okay, therefore, the what is the length and breadth of rectangle AEDO? See, AEDO. Okay, in which length is the AE and breadth is the AO. Therefore, I can write here AE into AO. Okay, first bracket plus area of right angle triangle ABE. What is the area of right angle triangle ABE? That is nothing but the 1/2 into length into height, which is equal to 1/2 into what is the length? AE. Sorry. Yes, AE. And what is the height? Height is the BC. I want to tell you again, the rectangle AEDO is equal to AE into AO and the area of right angle triangle ABE is nothing but, or which is equal to AE into BE, because AE is length and BE is height of these triangle. Okay, next, calculate the values of these factor. First of all, I calculate here the value of AE. What is AE? AE is equal to DO or OD, and OD is nothing but the T or time. Therefore, AE is equal to, I write here OD, which is equal to T. Then, next, what is AO? AO is nothing but the initial velocity. Initial velocity is the U. Therefore, I write here AO is equal to AD, which is equal to AD or which is equal to U. Okay? Then, plus 1 half into what is A? A we have already calculated here. And what is B? See, in previous lecture we calculate the value of B is nothing but the CA. See, BE means nothing but the these CA, and C is nothing but the CA is nothing but the CA is equal to 80. We have already seen in a equation number first. See, these three values we putting in these equation number one. Then what will get here? What we will get here? See, A that is nothing but the T into AO. AO means U plus 1/2 into what is A? A is the 1/2. A is T into what is B? B is 80. Okay. Now calculating this equation by rearranging this equation, TU or which is equal to UT, barabar. S is equal to we are calculating here what is S plus 1/2 T into T, T square. Therefore here is the into 80 square. See, therefore from this equation I can write here S is equal to UT plus 1/2 80 square. See, this is our equation number 2. UT, S is equal to UT plus 1/2 80 square. See what the equation describing or seeing here, told here, the equation told relation between velocity and time, or equation, the equation number 2 describing the relation between or information about the in which two factor, velocity and time, means how much time required to cover that particular distance we calculate here. Therefore we can also say here this equation is also known as velocity time equation. This is equation number 2. We will stop here.